In this problem, I've got a person with mass 80 kilograms climbing a ladder of length 5 meters, and the ladder itself has non-negligible mass, that's 15 kilograms. It's propped up against a smooth wall, meaning I don't have to worry about friction there. I know the angle of elevation is 50 degrees. And at the bottom, the ladder feels a static friction coefficient of 0.4. I'm trying to figure out the maximum height the person can climb before the ladder slips. And before I start doing any calculations, I want to figure out, why should there be a maximum height they can climb to before it slips? Like, what's going on physically? So I'm going to start looking at some force vectors in here. One of them is this contact point with the wall. There's a normal force exerted there that I'll call NW for wall. And then I have gravity pulling down on the center of mass of the ladder with a magnitude of ML times G. And then gravity is pulling down at the center of mass of the person. So I just estimated where that would be in the picture and put MP times G. And then at the contact point with the ground, I have the normal force exerted straight up. So I'll call that NF for the floor. And then I've got to think about which way does the static friction force point. And I see the normal force exerted by the wall pushing to the left, which just qualitatively thinking about the sum of the forces in the X direction, that means the static friction force must point to the right so that the X forces will sum to zero. And then real quick, I'm going to look at a qualitative torque analysis around the contact point with the ground to try to figure out what's going on. So I have two clockwise torques in my analysis, and they're caused by the force of gravity down on the center of mass of the ladder together with the force of gravity down on the person. Well, as this person climbs higher and higher and higher up the ladder, that torque due to their weight is increasing. That means my counterclockwise torque must increase, which means the normal force exerted by the wall increases. And that means my friction force pointing to the right must increase. So I guess what's happening here is we eventually get to the point where that rightward pointing static friction force is maxed out. So I can say that it's mu s times the normal force. All right, so now I get like why the ladder might slip when someone climbs higher and higher on it. And I need to get into the quantitative analysis of the problem. So the first thing I'm going to do is the torque analysis about the contact point with the ground. So the sum of all the torques around that axis must vanish. That means the clockwise torques must add up to the same as the counterclockwise torques. And I've got some difficult trig to do here. If I draw a perpendicular through the center of mass in the ladder, I've got to figure out what this angle is, so I can get the perpendicular component of the weight. Well, this is exactly the same diagram we've used dozens of times for inclined planes, and it just turned out that angle was the same as the angle of incline. And we're going to do the same thing at the location of the person. One last thing to do here is to realize that my angle of incline is an alternate interior angle with this angle for the normal force exerted by the wall. So that's going to be 50 degrees as well. Plugging all that in, and I'm going to stay symbolic for a while, I have my clockwise torques, mass of the ladder times g times the cosine of 50 degrees. I'll just leave it as a theta for now. Exerted through a lever arm of L over 2 because it's happening right at the center of the ladder. Then I have the mass of the person times g, cosine of the angle exerted through a lever arm of x, and that's the prize here. We're trying to find x. That's going to be the height the person is at when the friction force is maxed out. And then I have my counterclockwise torque exerted by the normal force at the wall, which is going to be nw sine of theta. It's happening at the end of the ladder, so the lever arm there is the entire length of the ladder l. Okay, so that's nice, but there's two unknowns in it. There's x and there's the normal force exerted by the wall, so I've got to keep going. And the first thing I'll do is to write down the sum of the forces in the x direction must be equal to zero. That means all the forces pointing to the right must be equal to all the forces pointing to the left. And there's not much going on there. I have the friction force pointing to the right, and I have the normal force exerted by the wall pointing to the left. So there's my second equation. And I'm making progress here, but I did introduce another unknown. It was the normal force exerted by the floor. So I need to write down another equation, and I'm going to go to the vertical force analysis. I could write it this way. All the forces pointing up must be equal to all the forces pointing down. So the normal force exerted by the floor is the only upward pointing force. and then I have the weight of the ladder and the weight of the person as the only forces pointing down. So this last equation allows me to actually write down a number for the normal force exerted at the floor if I wanted to, but I'm still going to keep it symbolic for a second. So I plug that NF in to my second equation, and I find out the normal force exerted by the wall is going to be mu S times NF, and I'm going to go ahead and do some factoring. When I write down NF, it's G times the sum of the two masses. Now I can plug that expression for the normal force at the wall back into my original torque equation, and I should be all set to actually put numbers into this thing. So I'm going to go down to the bottom, and I get ML G cosine theta times L over 2 plus MPG cosine theta times X is equal to mu S G times the quantity ML plus MP times L. So I didn't see a lot of advantage to staying symbolic here. I just went ahead and plugged in all the numbers at this step. So the mass of the ladder was 15 kilograms, G is 9.8, theta is 50 degrees, the length of the ladder is 5 meters, the mass of the person was 80 kilograms, my static friction coefficient was 0.4. Plug all that stuff in and smash it in your calculator, and you get 236.2 plus 503.9x equals 1426.4, solving for x. I get 2.36 meters, which means the person doesn't even make it halfway up the ladder before it begins to slip. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.